Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Friends, you might just take your seats for a moment. We gather this beautiful Tuesday afternoon, June the 6th, to pay a faithful farewell to Father Gerard O'Byrne. The family call him Gerard. His colleagues and friends call him Ger, and his beloved parishioners here in Rathangan and in early appointments in Port Arlington, Barris and Killy knew him simply as Father O'Byrne. It's been a long bedside vigil in Craddock House Nursing Home for around 9-10 days. When plans were put on hold as we waited on God to call Father Ger home. It was a great lesson for us all on the gift of life, the value of life, from the cradle to the grave, from the womb to the tomb. Our thoughts this afternoon are very much with Ger's brothers, John and Father Willie, his sisters-in-law, his brother-in-law, his nephew, Father Tom, and his other nephews and nieces, parishioners, friends, brother priests, and religious. Father Ger makes history today as he becomes the first parish priest of Rathangan to be buried in St. Patrick's Cemetery. Previously, Rathangan was attached to Kildare, and the pastors were laid to rest there. Of course, Ger was only the third parish priest here of Rathangan, and for him it makes huge sense and very much was his wish to be buried alongside the people he faithfully served for over 30 years. I'm conscious there are relatives and friends joining through Facebook Live and through the webcam. You're most welcome wherever you are this day. We're delighted you're with us in Rathangan. I'm very much delighted that Bishop Paul joins us, as indeed joining us on webcam is Ger's classmate and friend from their days in Rome, Bishop Michael from Mullingar. So wherever you are joining us from, you're most welcome, as indeed are all who are gathered here in this splendid Church of the Assumption and St. Patrick, on this wonderful afternoon as we give thanks for a life of faith. We prepare to offer these sacred mysteries in memory of a beloved pastor, brother, uncle, granduncle, and colleague. And so we stand as we call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of Father Gerard, your servant and priest, whom you honored with sacred office while he lived in this world, may exult forever in the glorious home of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We sit now and listen to God's word.
A reading from the book of Job. There is a season for everything. A time for every occupation under heaven. A time for giving birth, a time for dying. A time for planting, a time for uprooting. A time for building, a time for tearing down. A time for sorrow, a time for joy. A time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for making love, a time to refrain from making love, a time for finding, a time for losing, a time for saving, a time for throwing away, a time for mending, a time for tearing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking, a time for conflict, a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
reading is the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds, together with them, to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Please stand to greet the gospel.
Alleluia! 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 Alleluia!
I am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. Anyone who believes in me will have eternal life.
Alleluia! 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 Alleluia!
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On the first day of the week, two of the disciples were on their way to a village called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem. And they were talking together about all that had happened. Now, as they talked this over, Jesus himself came up and walked by their side. But something prevented them from recognizing him. When they drew near to the village to which they were going, he made as if to go on, but they pressed him to stay with them. "It is nearly evening," they said, "and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. Now, while he was with them at table, he took the bread and said the blessing. Then he broke it and handed it to them. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?" They set out at that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, "Yes, it is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then they told their story of what had happened on the road and how they had recognized him at the breaking of bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
The shorter version of Luke's account of the supper at Emmaus has that beautiful line, "It is nearly evening," they said, "and the day is almost over." It was last Saturday evening at around 25 minutes past five that Father Ger gently slipped into the arms of God. It was a journey where for days he had been accompanied by family and friends. A journey where the staff at Craddock House once again couldn't do enough to make that journey more comfortable They were there at every turn. And for you, John, and for Father Willie, this was the loss of another sibling, and you have lost too many in recent times. Around Jerry's bedside, stories were told, memories were relived, blessings were recounted, and vigil was kept day and night. Another line from St. Luke, they said to each other, did not our hearts burn within us as he talked with us on the road and explained the scriptures to us? Everyone has their story of Father Jerry. How he made their heart burn, his gentle pastoral style that accompanied many in their moments of joy and sorrow. I read some of those tributes on RIP.ie and on Facebook Live of the moments where Jer helped a family cope with grief. He was there. I even had an email yesterday morning from Fiji telling me how Jer was so supportive during a particular family bereavement back in 1968. So many stories, all told so well. When Jer was ordained in St. John Lateran Basilica in Rome on the 9th of March 1963, the only word he was asked, like every priest is asked to say on ordination day, is that word, present. And he has been a constant, faithful presence in the life of parishioners, family, and friends ever since. A presence in Port Arlington from the time of his ordination for 10 years. A presence in Boris from 1973 to 1984. And in Killy from 1984 to 1989, before becoming parish priest here in 1989. On Father Bill's appointment, he took on a gentler role as curate until his health necessitated a move to more full-time nursing care. Some months ago, on a visit to Craddock House, I gave him a copy of a book by his classmate, Bishop Michael Smith, on Vatican Council memories. As we sat together in Craddock House, his face lit up as I regaled stories from the book of the Rome of 1957 to 1963. What a time to be a clerical student, as John the 23rd announced his intention of convening the Ecumenical Council, Vatican II. No one then realized the import of that action. Some might add, some still don't. Joseph O'Connor's most recent book, My Father's House, is a curious read if we want to get some appreciation of the journey the young Gerard O'Byrne would have made, leaving Ballykeely and Ballon, leaving Knockbeg to travel to study for the priesthood as a Kildare and Loughlin seminarian. Gerard's other Kildare and Loughlin classmates who travelled with him in October 1957 were Sean Conlon, Sean is with us today, Dick Hogan, P.B. MacDonald, and the late Pat Ramsbottom. The subject of Joseph O'Connor's book is, of course, the Scarlet Pimpernel, Monsignor Hugh O'Flaherty from Kerry, who, we're told, saved many Jews from the Nazis and helped Allied personnel leave Rome and leave Italy. O'Flaherty would still have been a familiar figure around the Vatican and the Irish College when Jer and his 11 classmates arrived in Rome in October 57. He met them on the steps of St. Peter's, their first Sunday, and he took the 12 Irish seminarians for a tour of St. Peter's using a guidebook he himself had written in the Holy Year in 1950. 2023 is a year especially dedicated to the promotion of the diocesan priesthood. Over the past years, there have been 13 sets of brothers at different times ministering in Kildare and Loughlin. 13 sets of brothers. The death of Father Jerry sadly brings to an end that last set of brothers in active ministry. Mind you, Father Willie's curate, Matt Kelly, who's also with us, and his brother, Joe, both still very active. If Bishop Keogh had accepted both of them into the diocese, they would be the 14th set of brothers. Brothers, nephews, cousins in ministry show the importance still today of family promoting vocations. The home in Ballykeely and Ballon was without a doubt a home where vocations flourished. Jeroboam gave his life to his vocation. Pope Francis in Evangelii Gaudium reminds us a parish is the presence of the church in a given territory, an environment for hearing God's word, for growth in the Christian life, dialogue, proclamation, charitable outreach, worship, and celebration. There is so much to the living testimony of this man's ministry here and in earlier appointments. The daycare centre, the sheltered housing units, the parish welfare association, his works in the schools, primary and post-primary. Father Ger's willingness to pilot new programs, new ways of engaging with people on matters of faith. Ger was very aware the missionary impulse is not restricted to priestly ministry. He ensured others lived fully their baptismal calling. Sadly, the first thing that impeded Ger's life, I think, were his feet, his walking. And that was so unfortunate for a man who loved his walks. Luke's Gospel has the two disciples on their feet journeying to Emmaus. They're slow to recognize it is Jesus who walks with them. We know Ger will have no difficulty recognizing the Lord in eternity, and the Lord will have absolutely no difficulty recognizing him. I acknowledge particularly this afternoon those who were very close to Father Ger. You all know who you are. Particular mention to Father Bill, Katrina, Mary the Secretary, and Martina. In appointing Bill here in 2019, I knew that Ger would have someone who would be a very good friend to him, and he was all of that. In the words of St. John Henry Newman, we pray that the Lord may support us all day long until the shades lengthen and the evening comes. And the busy world is hushed. The fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in his mercy, may he give Ger and all of us a safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at last. Amen. Stand now for our prayer of the faithful. I invite those forward who are leading us in those prayers. Gathered at this requiem for Father Ger this day, we turn, Lord, with our thoughts, our prayers, and our intercessions.
For Father Ger, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray in thanksgiving for the blessing of Father Ger's ministry in Rathangan, Killy, Burris, and Port Arlington, for his kind and gentle ways in tending to his parishioners, for his concern for those in need and those leading us in prayer and worship. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the sorrowing family of Father Ger and all who mourn his passing, that together we may find strength and consolation in the faith that Father Ger witnessed to in his priesthood. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
for all who cared for and supported Father Gerard, especially all the staff of Craddock's House Nursing Home. May the Lord bless and reward them for their goodness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our departed relatives and friends, and all who are close to us in this life, we remember especially Father Gerard's parents, Thomas and Anna, brothers Edward, Donal and Hugh, and his sister Mary. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, we offer all these prayers, spoken and unspoken, through Christ our Lord. We take our seats now as we have the offertory.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that through these holy mysteries, Jer, your servant and priest, may behold with clarity forever what he faithfully ministered here, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Dennis, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Remember your servant, Jared, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you after passing through this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
We stand and pray. Ornahar, Atornav, Ganin Fadanam, Gudagadal Riot, Ganin to the Holler and Talav, Marnin Ternav. Honor on there, Tuduin you, August Maudona Vecta, Maravahamede Vecuna Fain, August Alexion Gaho, Oxertion Owal. Sirshin O'Gok Ulkin Pimid Urtihirna, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's turn to offer each other a sign of that peace. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Sha'e'unde, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
And now we'll have a reflective piece, Healer of My Soul. Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God, for Father Ger, your servant and priest, that as you made him a steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality as unveiled in heaven, through Christ our Lord. And just before the prayers of commendation and farewell, we'll kindly take our seats as Father Willie may say a few words to us.
Good afternoon, everyone. Just to say that on behalf of John and all our extended family, we'd like to express our great thanks to all who are here today to celebrate Ger's life and to thank you for your support. Bishop Dennis succeeded in stealing most of the things I was going to say, and I should have guessed, but anyway. He has been a great friend to Gerd and to me. And indeed, not only thanking him for his celebration today, which was lovely, and his kind words, but throughout Ger's illness particularly, he was a great friend, I must say, and we thank you most sincerely, Bishop Dennis. I remember when he rang Gerard to tell him that he was Bill Kemmy, he had eyed him out to come here to Rathangan to give him a dig out. And Ger and I were in a hotel down in Wexford, actually, and Ger's hearing aids weren't working too well that day, so he had to put them on to me. But it all worked out wonderfully well, and Father Bill, we owe you a huge debt of gratitude for all your kindness to Ger over the special time of his illness, the last 14 months or so. You have no idea how much he has done for us and for Ger, and I'm calling him Ger, by the way, and you notice that. Not all the O'Byrnes called him Gerard. But anyway, Bill, thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, appreciate it. Well done. Good night. To the people of Rathangan, all I can say is that you are a great, great community. Ger absolutely loved being here in Rathangan. He loved every moment of it. And he told me over and over again, sometimes when we'd be having a little, maybe meal out or a little something to go with it, he told me many and many times that there's no place he'd rather be than in Rathangan. And that's a great tribute to all of you. So thank you for making him so welcome and for all your cooperation. And I know you loved him, and he loved you too. He was 34 years in this parish, which is a long time. Usually bishops move fellas, but I think Ger was immovable anyway, so there was no point. Want to say too that there are people who have been extremely good to him over all those years. He's made great friends, I know, but I'm not going to mention names because it would be just impossible to seek out somebody and without leaving out others. So I just want you all to know, you know yourselves who you are, and I want you to know that he loved you dearly and he found great support and friendship and love through all of you. So thank you for that. The care that Bishop Dennis mentioned that Ger got in Craddock House nursing home was unbelievable. Honestly, I have to say, and I know John would say the same and all the family, that it was exceptional. They were really wonderful people there, and it was so helpful to us to see the great love and compassion and care that he received. So to Breed and Carl and all their staff there, in the amazing staff in the nursing home, I want to say on behalf of all the family, a huge thank you to you, and we really do appreciate it. You deserve great credit, I must say. Ger was a great friend to myself, to John, to all the family. And so signed, there's so many nieces and nephews here today and extended members of the families. He was a quiet man, but he somehow had that bit of charism that carried him through, and we saw that all the time and loved him for all of that. So I vividly remember the morning that Ger left for Rome. I was only in short trousers, of course. It was October, and I remember my mother giving him a postcard. He was to post it back to her from Zurich, because the plane had to come down a few times to get fuel. In those days, it was only a propeller plane, a Viscount, I think. And I went on the bicycle down to Ballon to serve mass on that morning, and I was telling the sacristan, a grand lady called Mrs. Flynn, that Ger was heading out to Rome with a few of the other lads who are Joe Delaney and Sean Conlon are here. And she said, well, God send him safe and I won't live to see him ordained. But she did, and it was great. So now, just again to say thank you all for your kindness and for your love for Ger. And I'm going to finish repeating that prayer that Ger often said, and Bishop Dennis already repeated it, but may the Lord support us all the day long till the shades lengthen and the evening falls and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in his mercy may he give us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at last. May he rest in peace.
I invite you to stand now for the prayer of commendation and farewell. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Father Ger, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Father Ger again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. We pray quietly as Ger's remains are blessed with water, the waters of baptism, and in a sense with the thurible as he is indeed a temple of the Holy Spirit.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray to you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Father Ger, your servant, your priest. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he has committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace now, let us begin our journey to St. Patrick's Cemetery with Father Ger's remains, and may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May may you have eternal life. I invite the priest to gather with me around Father Gerard's coffin as we sing together the Salve Regina. And there's refreshments in the community centre for everyone after the burial.
Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O Father William, Father Tom, and all their behalf, many thanks for being here. A particular word of thanks to our wonderful choir and musicians who were splendid during the liturgy this day. Let's join now in our final hymn as we lead our procession after.